Hey everybody, Dave from UMI Performance. We're working on our 78 Cutlass in this episode. We're gonna install the mid-mount system from Holley on our LS3, install that engine, and we're gonna put our bowler transmission in. So our crate motor come with all the accessories we needed on the front, the water pump, pulleys. So we're actually pulling all that off and we're installing a Holley mid-mount unit. We used black, trying to go with kind of a stealth mode, as factory looking as we can get.
We're also going to remove the water pump and our new system that he's going to put together here. We tried to go with more of a sleek stock looking, kind of a sleeper look, so we went with some black components. So he's installing the water pump pulley and getting ready to throw this on our new Pace Performance LS3.
So here we're installing the water pump pulley, and the actual water pump has all the accessory mounts for all your extra accessories you're going to see added on here.
We also want to make sure that our heater works in this car, so Dave's tightening the new barb fittings on there.
Here's the alternator, so we have a nice alternator on here to power the tunes and power the engine.
So we know we want to get this thing steering right, so we reached out to turn one and got one of their power steering pumps. So Dave's going to assemble this and get it back together.
Now, don't make the same mistake I did here. If you look close, I am installing that pulley on backwards, where I had to actually pull it back off. I actually bent the first one and had to pick up a second and reinstall it properly. Next up, we're gonna install our AC compressor, crank pulley, and our idler pulley. Pretty simple. There's a couple specialty tools, one of which engages the flywheel to keep the crank tight so you could get that torque down properly. We decided we wanted to go with a little sleeker valve cover setup. So we got these two-piece jobs. They look awesome, but the problem we run into is some fitment issues in the engine bay. We have a factory AC car. We didn't want to cut up the box. It was really nice. So we ended up having to switch back to a factory style valve cover, and we used some LS3 fiberglass covers over that so we can go with a more sleek appearance. These would be awesome in a different application where you're looking to hide those coils and go with a little more old school appearance.
Now that we've got the valve covers on, the next step is going to be motor mounts, if we can find them.
Part number 2406 is the frame side engine mounts. So you can see that there's a number of slots in here. It fits multiple years and multiple engine styles for Buick, Olds, Pontiac, and Chevrolet. So got a nice variety on there. Double shear mount, and it actually holds the LS engine side mounts like this 2329. Our 2329 has poly, so it's a nice combination of performance and comfort. Bolts right onto the LS engine, frame notch up. When you put this in here, it's a nice double shear mount, nice and strong, but still nice and comfortable for cruising and high performance use. This 2406, 2329 combo allows direct bolt and installation of an LS into your 78-88 GM G body car. As always, technical support is always available at support.
We're trying to put an engine in the car, Ramey. Let's stop talking about it. Come on.
Here we are setting in place a set of American Racing headers. The guys out there fixed us up, make a great fitting LS swap header. No clearancing issues anywhere on the header or on the frame.
So we're getting ready to drop the Pace LS3 finally in the Cutlass. It's been a long, long wait coming. So we're just being careful, making sure we don't scratch anything. Also make sure you put your headers down in there before the engine, because there's no way to fish them up from the bottom after the engine is installed.
And pulling our headers to the side to give us the clearance we need. It's a little bit of a tight fit, but no issues, as long as you take your time.
We're also using a fancy ratchet strap to help level out the engine. You know, we're all just a couple of guys here working on stuff and doing the stuff we love. So sometimes you don't always have the correct equipment, but you can always improvise. And we're getting the headers tightened up to the new LS3, making sure we don't knock any spark plugs off and break those, getting the motor mounts all lined up. Sometimes it's easier to leave the chassis side of the motor mount loose. So whenever you're fitting your engine in there, you can move it back and forth to make sure it's sitting where it needs to be before you tighten the motor mounts down.
And here you can see we're starting to run into those issues with the valve cover clearance. So we ended up switching back to the factory LS3 valve covers.
So now that we have the engine installed, we know we're gonna need something to hold that power. So we got that Drew Street Series here from Bowler Transmissions. This here's the 4L65, made for about 500 horsepower there. This here is the computer for that with the old wirings. This also has one of them coolers there. Them transmissions get hot there when you're racing and when you're doing the burnouts. We also trust this Royal Purple here, Max ATV, ATF here. This stuff's actually purple, you know, not red. So then, the directors here, this is a birth certificate of when the guys over there at Bowler. Chester over there at Bowler, I know Chester, don't know him personally, but I want to shake his hand someday. Then there's a couple pieces of hardware there. And we're just going to get this in the car, factory car behind us, 78 Caprice. Oh, that's not a Caprice, that's Cutlass, that's the wrong one. But we're going to get her in the car and then we're going to drive it.
Here we have the Bowler Performance Transmission. We've been a long time partner with Bowler Transmissions. They build pretty much any kind of transmission that we ask of them. They're always bulletproof. They always work really nice. So shout out to our friends at Bowler. Here you can see the torque converter is already installed. So the guys are using the transmission jack to get the transmission up into place. American Racing headers peeking out there. Transmission jack makes it nice. The guys can raise it up, get it all lined up, and it should connect to the engine pretty seamlessly here in a second. These engines, like most engines, have a set of dowels that go into the bell housing of the transmission or the scatter shield area on the automatic transmission. And that gets the transmission center line and the crankshaft center line perfect with each other. So once you get those dowels lined up, you can push the transmission right into place. Like and subscribe for more build content. We release build content every month. If you have any questions about our race-proven suspension systems, check out umiperformance.com.